I want you to clap your hands, stomp your feet, jump up and down, do anything that you want to do. Yeah!
Stevie Wonder was discovered by Ronald White, who was one of the miracles.
I mean, I remember the first time I saw Stevie Wonder. He came to Motown. He was this kid about 9, 10, 11 years old, maybe, and he played the harmonica and the bongos.
He had great rhythm, great attitude, and he was just moving his head, and he was playing and going and doing everything. But I was wondering, what's the big deal? Because I wasn't in the market for a drummer. But then he left the drums, and he started playing the bongos. And he did that, and it was okay. It was nice, you know. I wasn't thrilled with his voice particularly, but it was okay. He was good. And then he went to the harmonica. Now that impressed me. He had a great sense of humor. He took advantage of his blindness while other people were trying to feel sorry for him. He was making jokes about him and them.
The Temptation, they had soul, but you have to learn how to present it.
Watch out, here comes that bad boy.
Oh, yeah.
Watch out, here comes that bad boy.
All right.
Watch out, here comes that bad boy.
Woo! Boy. The artists at Motown were lacking movement, just polish, period.
George Anna from the Marvelettes walked out on the stage. They said, "Not the Marvelettes." And she walked out on the stage with her eyes wide and chewing gum and looking at all the people and said, "You know, it's just country style." And I said, "It's not going to work. We got to have a training course."
You know, they needed polishing, man.
Artist development was started by my sisters, Anna and Gwen. They put together some terrific forces.
These women were beautiful, and they dressed well, and they looked good, and they were the hot women in Detroit. I mean, they were just not only beautiful, but they were smart.
The moves are so good and all, the choreography. And Soupy was telling me that they actually teach you all that at Motown.
Yes, we have a department, and we call it Artist Development. And
that's great.
In this department, we have a choreographer, the greatest, Charlie Atkins. He used to be in vaudeville with a dance act.
So Charlie Atkins was different from most choreographers that I know because he's a syncopated person. I mean, he does syncopated moves.
3, 4, 2, 3, 4. All right?
All right.
See, now, you just have to put a little style into it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just like walking.
Charlie Atkins, Harvey Fuqua, they were the ones that would take us in artist development. And after Charlie would get through staging us, then we would segue from dancing to vocalizing.
I brought in Mr. Maurice King, who was an arranger, big band arranger, who was right there in Detroit.
So between the two of us, we would get together and design the whole program.
You really got a hold on me.
The most important thing was to give them some physical drama.
Come on, hold me.
They were doing moves, but the moves didn't have any association with what the song had to say.
Tied up.
what I liked about it and what was unlike the other major companies was they were grooming their artists, and they were grooming them for the long run.
They asked me to open up the finishing school there, Motown Finishing School, because the youngsters, you know, they came from humble beginning, and some were rude and crude from the street and the project. But with me, it isn't where you come from, it's where you're going.
She taught me how to be a lady and that everybody's beautiful. If you're not born with it, you can develop it. She gave us a real long lecture the first day.
The first thing we're going to work with is class. And you're also going to be trained to appear in number one places around the country, and even before the king and queen. Those youngsters looked at me and said, that one was crazy. All we want is a hit record.
She was the brunt of a lot of jokes, I'll say that, because as young girls, we didn't take her seriously. The minute you walked through the door, that was it. She would say, stop all that stuff, you know. Stand up like this, ladies.
Keep the torso straight.
Never bend over and have your backside.
You do not protrude the buttocks.
Shoulders back. Mm.
1, 2, 3. Push, push, step. Lift and point. Lift and point. So it's like treading. And then instead of walking, you're beginning to glide.
You see, people don't realize that Berry is more than talent. He made them people stars. He taught them how to walk on the stage. He taught them how to go to dinner. He taught them how to hold their fork, their spoon, how to wipe their mouth with a napkin. I got credit for keeping my artists moving and dancing and choreographed, and I was complaining like hell against that stuff, you know? Even though I liked the concept, and I, of course, okayed the budget, and I did all that stuff, but I said, don't bother me. Don't bother me. I'm in the studio. I want to make hits. Hits is my business. Leave my Billy alone.
Artists were so groomed and so cool.
Right.
We used to grow up wanting to be them, to emulate them, just to, you know, do the Temptations steps, do the Four Top steps.
One thing that always struck you about a Motown act was they gave you more than your money's worth, not just on the record. But if you were lucky enough to see him in a concert or on television, they gave you a show.
So when you saw a Motown artist hit that stage, man, you felt an electric happening taking place in front of you that you were caught up in. And sometimes it got like almost going to church. You know, it got that happy. You know, when like when the old Baptist church, when the sisters would get happy, that's what would happen.
Never a thought in my mind that we should not continue working with them. That just never came up. We were gonna work with them until they got hits, because they had that magic, and we wanted the world to know what
we knew.
Smokey wrote a song for us in the early days, and maybe no one will remember this except me, but are you just a breathtaking, first sight, soul shaking, one night love making, next day heartbreaking guy?
One of my favorite Motown stories is going to the Apollo, seeing the Supremes, and they were real cute. They came on very early in the show.
Thank you.
There was something about the lead singer. She had something that was very likable.
We had been looking at the Supremes to do some songs of ours. One of the songs in particular that comes to mind was the Where Did Our Love Go?
I expected them to bring us something that was also soulful and, you know, Motown sound. And they brought us this record. Baby, baby.
And they thought it was a little bit infantile. Baby, baby, well, chank, 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 chank.
You know, this song is not gonna do it. You know, we need a hit. We really, and I mean, I cried. I was, you know, I mean.
Baby, baby, baby.
Originally for the Marvelettes, and the Marvelettes just flatly refused to do it, and they thought it was less than what they were supposed to do as far as the material goes.
You came into my heart now, so tenderly, with a burning love, and that stings like a bee.
And at first on the tour, it was like Jean Pitney, the Shirelles, yeah, and others. We were the and others. And we went out every night to say, ladies and gentlemen, the Supremes. And was like, yay. And then towards about 2 or 3 weeks into the tour, it says, ladies and gentlemen, the Supremes. Yay! You know, people were out. And we were backstage saying, what are they talking about? You know, it's like us. And the song had become a hit while we were on this tour.
And it turned out to be the first of the 13 number ones in a row.
They think that because you can sing that you get up on a stage and like magic it happens. I don't think it was magical for any of us. I think all of us worked really hard.
Come see upon me.
It was December 27th, 1964. I was 10 years old when I tuned in to watch the Ed Sullivan Show. That was 29 years ago. And I haven't seen that clip from that show since then. And it was a moment that changed my life.
Our tops on the record charts this week is Come See About Me, as sung by these girls here, the Supremes, three youngsters from Detroit.